Hello everyone and welcome to your channel Share Cause You Care. How are you doing today? Well, in this video, I would be explaining how to use your Oxford Advantage app to create a lesson plan. Please watch the previous video on Oxford Advantage app explained. I would be providing the link in the description box below. You can also click on the top to get to the video directly. So without any delay, let's start. Once you have logged in to your Oxford Advantage Integrated Learning Solution app, you would come to this part or this page. Your interface would be something like this. I have explained how to use the app in my previous video. So today our topic is how to create a lesson plan using Oxford Advantage Learning Solution. Well, to be very honest, this is very easy. All you need to do, or all we need to do, is to learn what are the process, what are the steps that involves in creating a lesson plan. Let us divide our lesson plan into different parts. First, you would find on the top, there are total numbers of lesson plans. So in 5th SST Social Studies, you would find 120 lesson plans are there. Alright, and these are the following lesson plans. It's divided into pages. So on the top, you would be able to see there are certain options. The first is all. So you are automatically on all option. So that is why you would be able to see all the 120 lesson plans that is written over here. Second is shared. I'll come to this option later on once we have created, because it is something that if you share your lesson plan, then only you would be able to see it over here. So let me show you one. Well, I have not shared any, so there is none showing over here. So once you share, it's going to come over here. Next is the recommended plan that is recommended for you. That is this thumbs up sign that is there, you would find in front of all the lesson plan that is recommended for you. So all and recommended is quite the same, but there are certain lesson plans you would not find it recommended because it is given for your benefit. You can use them, but it is not recommended. The next or the fourth one is my lessons. That means you, once you have created or it is your creation, because I have mentioned before that over here you can definitely go ahead edit the lesson plans according to your own desire. So once you click on my lessons, they would show you how many lesson plans you have created. Over here I have created 2 lesson plans just to show you that once you create a lesson plan, it would reflect in this tab, my lessons. All right, and the moment it is created by you, over here the sign would be a person sign. You would be able to see the difference, right? Recommended is a thumbs up sign, and once you have created, it's a person sign. All right, now let's come to all 4 tabs that are there on the top. On the right hand side, you would find create, delete and plan. Create, let's move on with the first one. Create means you want to create your own lesson plan. They are going to give you a skeleton, they are going to give you a format, and in that format you can type, you can add, you can delete whichever things that you want, how you want your class, how you want to conduct your class. It's absolutely your own desire and you can go ahead with it. If you think that you want to delete any of the lesson plan, if you think that you want to delete any of your lesson plan, any of the recommended lesson plans, you can surely delete from here. But it is not showing over here because you have not selected any. Over here, you would be able to see an option. Once you click on that, see the delete plan has come. The delete option has come. So if you delete, they are going to ask you, are you sure you want to delete or not? So you can just go ahead and choose whichever you want. over here I don't want to delete anything, so I'm just clicking on no. Now, the last one is plan. It is completely a different thing because it is coming into the calendar section. So yes, obviously it is linked with the calendar. So you can plan in such a way that every lesson plan that you modify, you can put it in the calendar, and you can go to the calendar and you can see which lesson plan has been allotted for which day. Yes, now this is quite a different thing, so I would be making a different video for this. Now, this lesson plan, the first and all the options, you would be able to find many details over here. So for example, so it's SST lesson plan 1.1, means chapter 1, first day. It's SST lesson plan 1.2, chapter 1, second day. So this goes on like this. So the moment you would see over here in this SST lesson plan 2.1, that means second chapter, first lesson plan. This is how it is. Below, you would be able to see there are many options. The first one is the duration. The second one, the number of time it has been used. You can use it many times, so it's going to reflect over here. I have not used it, so over here it's showing zero. On the right hand side, there are three options: play, edit, and plan. So these three options signifies that you want to see this lesson plan. Once you click on it, it is going to show you what's there inside. The second one is your edit. That means you want to edit this one, this particular lesson plan. So you have to click on this and you have to click on edit or plan. And this one is a plan. So that means over here, if you click on this, you will go automatically go to the calendar where you can plan your, or you can put in your planner in which day you want to go ahead and use this lesson plan. So let's create one. So we would be using a model sample over here, and over here let's edit. Let's first see play. Once you click on the play option, you would be able to see your interface something like this. It is a set of lesson plan that has already been given. So what you need to do is that you need to follow it and you need to go ahead with this lesson plan. So for example, like warm up, this is also like there are many procedures. There are many warm up, we know it, the procedure. What are the things that we need to do? What are the activities that can be do? Wrap up, that means you have completed the class. Now, what exactly you want to tell your students while completing or finishing the class. And then is a homework that you would like your students to complete at home. So this is how exactly it is. And with everything, you'll have a time duration over here. All right. 15 seconds, 15 seconds, or 5 seconds, the total number. But it is totally depend. It totally depends on you how long you want to proceed with each and every lesson plan. Okay, this is a model lesson plan, and it is for chapter 1, day 1. 1.1, chapter 1, day 1. So this was all the play button all about. Now let's go to edit, because you might think that instead of creating a whole new lesson plan, this particular lesson plan, if I edit it, it might be useful for me. So you can definitely go and click on the edit, and you would be able to see the same lesson plan. It is broken into pieces so that you can write down and you can edit it according to your own demand. So the first is lesson plan name over here. First and foremost thing, please remember, once you edit it, Once you edit a particular lesson plan that has been given by Oxford, it will never change the original lesson plan. So, suppose you are using this lesson plan, you are editing this lesson plan, it would never directly alter the recommended lesson plan that has been provided by them. Rather, they are going to create a second copy and they are going to put it in your tab, that means My Lesson. So for that, you need to change the name that is there on the top. So lesson plan, SST lesson plan, chapter 1, let's take it. So duration, it's like 35 minutes or 40 minutes approximately it would be there. Prerequisite knowledge or knowledge checking, whichever it is, how it is there. Student knows what is a globe, what a globe is. You can ask, do you know what is a globe? This is how you can do. Specific objective. So what is the objective of this particular day? Discuss the purpose of latitude longitude. All right, you can also say that there is another thing that you want to discuss. For example, if you take it for 40 minutes, so you have ample amount of time, so you can definitely discuss two topics at the same time. So discuss the purpose of longitude and latitude. You can also say characteristics of longitude. You also want to discuss. So there are two things that you want to discuss. Now skill set. Skill set means what are the things that the students are going to learn. Whenever you will see in your lesson plan option, there is add or remove option. That means the Oxford Advantage app, they have provided you with a list. So you just need to click on it. And you would find in front of you there are list of skill set which you think that after learning this the student might acquire. So you can select, like for example, positive self concept, self-awareness. I don't think self-awareness is there in this chapter. Problem solving you can also add. Reasoning you can add. There are many things that you need to know. Once you have completed it, you just need to scroll down and you would be able to find add or remove option. So once you click on it, you would find that it has been, the all the things that you have selected just now are there, over there have been selected. Now the next option is learning outcomes. So what are the things that you think that after teaching this set is the outcome? So again, you need to click on it. Now, let me tell you that there are many lists that takes time to come. So if you find that it is taking time, so do not have to worry. Due to network problem or any other problem, it takes time to come. So there is no problem. Again, so over here you can see that it's taking time. So there's no problem. It's something like this, a set of lists that would come in front of you. Again, you have to select and you have to move. Now over here is an option. In addition to school, make this lesson plan available on My Class app and www.oxfordadvantage.com. So if you select over here, well, it's selected. This is something that will come to share. Yes, the one that I was mentioning before about the shared option, after the all button, all option is shared. So once you clicked on it, you would be able to find that you have shared this lesson plan for the other teachers to see, so they can also use your lesson plan. And you are also providing Oxford to see what sort of lesson plans that you have created, and it can also help them to create something more and helpful for us. So once you click on next, and over here the second tab will come. The first thing that we have entered, the lesson plan details we have already entered. After clicking the next, we have come to selected resources. Now over here, all you need to do is that you need to select resources. That means what are the resources that you want to use? Select resources. Now, different types of things, the warm-up, procedure, wrap-up, homework. For everything, you can select the process. You can select the resources. So you just need to click. There are descriptions that you can write down over here. Alright. And like procedure is going to be big one. So over here, click and you would be able to see what are the things that are there. You can save it the description. Now, the second box is something important. On the right hand side, you would be able to see that there are some interactive sessions or some resources that has been provided by Oxford. Alright, once you click on it, so now you need to see it, right? So once you click on it, you would be able to find something like this, a page. So over here is an eye. It's a preview button. So once you click it, you would be able to see what is the resource that has been provided by Oxford, whether you want to use it or not, whether you want to put it or implement it. So here you see the features of latitude and longitude. So it's an differentiation column that is there, show answer, submit and all the things. So if you want to put, I'm just clicking on the cross button. So if you think that this is helpful for you, just press it with your left, just put a left click and press it and just drag it over here and release it. You would find your resource has been saved over here. Now the next one, if you want to go ahead, you can also drag and you can keep it over here. Now you think that over here you would be able to see the resource. There are two things that you have selected. Now you think these are not enough, you need some more, so you can click on add resource in the you can click on the add resource below, and there are two options, click and resource, link and resource. Once you click on link, it's going to show you a page where you can upload a link from YouTube. Yes. So you can go to the YouTube, you can get something on latitude, longitude, what is a globe. You can put a name, you can give a name to it, which is mandatory. The star mark is mandatory. And you have to select the duration. It's like 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes, whichever, whatever it is there. And you can put some descriptions. And over here, you have to copy the URL over here. You have to copy the URL. For those who do not know what is a URL, let me show you over here what is a URL. URL is nothing but the link that is there on your address bar. So you can click, see this. Once you click on it, you would be able to see this. There is a link on the address bar. Just click over here and copy and bring this link and paste it over here. That's it. So you can describe purpose. Learning, I agree, and upload the link. That's it. So you would be able to see that the links have been, resources have been successfully updated. It's going to take some time, and that's it. All right. Now you see over here, ABC has been uploaded. Just you click on it, drag to the point, and leave it. That's it. It is done. So you have selected all the resources, and it is done. And after you have finished, just click on next. Once you click on next, you would be able to move to the next tab, that is preview and save. Preview means whatever you have edited and how you have edited, you would be able to see everything. The changes that you have made, and I see over here, what are the questions, do they know math, everything, three interactive sessions and everything that you have done. We have not changed anything in the homework and wrap-ups. In the previous procedures, we have made some changes and everything. So after this, you click on save and that's it, lesson plan updated. So you have successfully updated your lesson plan on your Oxford Advantage app. And it's again, once you have clicked on save, it's again going to come to the point where you have started. And to see and check out, you need to click on my lesson because you have created it. So you need to click on my lesson and you would be able to see lesson plan chapter 1. This is right now you have created. So again over here it's play, edit. Again if you want to edit or if you want to put to the planner, that means in the calendar. So I hope this has solved all your queries. If you have anything else, if you want to ask anything else, if you want to know, please do comment in the comment section below. I would be very happy to help you and solve as much as possible. Thank you so much.